Have you ever looked under a rock and seen something scurrying away and realized it was a scorpion? Or have you ever wondered if a scorpion that is venomous could actually kill a human? Well, guys and gals, today in this video, we'll be looking at the 10 most dangerous scorpions you probably haven't seen before ever. And also in our list, we have a scorpion that actually spits venom at people. So guys, stick around to the end. So let's start. Number 10 is the yellow-legged burrowing scorpion. You'll find this species in certain regions of Africa, such as Botswana, Mozambique, South Africa, Tanzania, and Zimbabwe. This particular scorpion generally prefers drier areas, but is known to be able to tolerate quite wide temperature extremes, from mildly frosty to almost baking at more than 40 degrees centigrade. As the name would suggest, it is very good at digging burrows and has been known to dig as deep as 1.5 meters. Like many scorpions, it is venomous, although not much research has been done to determine how toxic it can be. It's believed it can cause quite severe sickness, but should not be fatal. Unusually, they have been seen hissing at potential predators or when disturbed. Number 9 is the Tanzanian red-clawed scorpion. As the name would suggest, you can find the Tanzanian red-clawed scorpion across the African state of Tanzania, hidden under rocks in hollowed-out fallen logs or burrows that other animals have used previously. It is not one of the larger scorpions in the world, typically measuring around 9 to 13 centimeters in length. It looks as you might expect, very much like a typical scorpion, and is said to look very much like an emperor scorpion. As you might expect, they have a deep red coloration on their claws, with a deep black body color. The Tanzanian red-clawed scorpion likes nothing more than to chow down on a banquet of insects, amphibians, rodents, and other small mammals. It is best not to annoy one of these guys, as if they don't severely injure your finger with their pinchers, they could get you with their sting. While this will inject venom into you, you'll find it incredibly painful, but it shouldn't be life-threatening. Number 8 on today's list is the emperor scorpion. Indigenous to the tropical rainforests and savanna regions of much of West Africa, including Nigeria, Ivory Coast, Ghana, and other close by countries, the emperor scorpion can be found in burrows, beneath rock formations, leaf litter, and other loose coverings, preferably close to termite mounds if they can locate one. The emperor scorpion is the biggest of all the scorpions by bulk, but this is not actually the longest. You should expect an emperor scorpion to grow to around 20 centimeters in length and about 30 grams in weight. Like all scorpions, these guys try to stay out of the way when they're not hunting, so their dark blue or sometimes black colorations help them to stay undisturbed as much as possible until they get the chance to go hunting for food. The emperor scorpion has a pretty wide diet as far as scorpions go, preferring insects, spiders, and even lizards. If you were keeping one as a pet, yes, people do keep scorpions as pets, then expect to feed yours at least one full cricket every other day. An adult emperor scorpion is more than capable of stinging and injecting venom. However, the level of toxin is not normally a threat to human life, but it will sting severely. At number 7, we have the Brazilian yellow scorpion. As you may have guessed, you'll find this scorpion in most parts of Brazil, in both urbanized areas of Rio de Janeiro and other more rural locations. The hacking down of the Brazilian rainforest is bringing the Brazilian yellow scorpion into contact with humans much more frequently than it has ever done before, and is causing major problems with envenomations. Unfortunately, it's not the biggest scorpion in the world by any means, typically only getting as big as around 3 centimeters in length, which is likely to make it even more difficult to see, and more likely for it to come in contact with an unsuspecting human. It is, as the name would suggest, colored yellow, being lighter in coloration on the legs and darker on its trunk area. Given the choice, the Brazilian yellow scorpion loves nothing more than dining on its favorite meal, the cockroach. Once again, its preference for an insect that loves nothing more than to hang out in areas where there are plenty of humans causes regular conflict, something that is growing exponentially every year. Get stung by one of these guys and you're gonna know about it. Your body will likely get hit by a tidal wave of problems, including fever, high agitation, tremors, sweating, vomiting, diarrhea, and more. If you're strong and fit, you should get over it. But if not, then a coma and potentially death will be the end result. Number 6 on the list is the spitting thick-tailed black scorpion. Found in most of southern Africa, the spitting thick-tailed black scorpion will spend most of its time living under rocks and dead leaf litter, mostly in dry desert areas. It is a fairly big scorpion, growing to up to 25 centimeters in length, with a big dark brown or black body and small, lighter colored pinchers, which tend to suggest it's highly venomous. These guys will try to go after anything they think can be successfully overpowered in terms of what they can eat. This can include amphibians, small mammals and rodents, spiders, and even other scorpions. The spitting, thick-tailed black scorpion is classified as very dangerous by the South African Snakebite Institute, and rightly so, due to the fact that it can inject venom by stinging, as you might have expected, but also, as the name suggests, by spitting it at you too. Get it in your eye, and you'll have a major problem. Number 5 today is the Arabian fat-tailed scorpion. This dangerous little fellow can be found in the desert areas of northern Africa and Middle Eastern states. Typically light brown colored, or potentially reddy brown, or even black, the Arabian fat-tailed scorpion will grow up to 10 centimeters in length, making them one of the smaller scorpions on our list. You will probably have to wait until nightfall to be able to see one of these guys, as this is when they do most of their hunting, where they try to grab anything smaller than itself, or anything it thinks it can overpower. In terms of how much of a threat to humans these guys are, well, let's put it this way. You really don't want to get stung. Their venom is potentially fatal if it gets into the bloodstream, more so if you're not overly fit, or in poor health generally. It has a neurotoxic venom that results in victims being paralyzed and dying from suffocation. Number 4 on the list is the yellow fat-tailed scorpion. Like its cousin, the Arabian fat-tailed scorpion, this guy is normally to be found in deserts and other dry areas of northern Africa and the Middle East. Again, they're not the biggest scorpions that you can find, but they will grow up to an average size of 12 centimeters and live for up to 7 years. The yellow fat-tailed scorpion just loves to eat crickets, using its tail to sting its prey, holding it in its claws until the venom destroys the insides of the insect it has captured, allowing it to suck out the juice. Nice, huh? Just make sure it doesn't sting you, though. It's nasty, real nasty. If you do get stung and can't get medical help, expect to begin to suffocate with potential cardiac arrest and even unstoppable bleeding of the brain. Number 3 on our list of top 10 most dangerous scorpions is the Deathstalker scorpion. The Deathstalker scorpion is also normally found in North Africa, but can also be seen in parts of Central Asia and even India. It is typically around 6 centimeters long and has a dark yellow coloration over most of its body, with a darker gray color across the back and the ends of its sting. Like other scorpions, it will eat most insects, worms, and centipedes, but will also partake in a spot of cannibalism if it is on the point of starvation. The Deathstalker will not normally kill a healthy human being, but if it stings a young child, elderly person, or anyone not overly fit and healthy, then it can be fatal. The risk of death is normally due to anaphylactic shock. At number 2 is the Arizona bark scorpion. Yep, I'm sure you've guessed that this fellow can be found in and around the areas of Arizona, specifically the Sonoran Desert and areas of northern Mexico. A relatively small scorpion at only 8 centimeters in length and with a dark orange coloration that is almost rust-colored, that's perfect for desert dwelling. Even though they live in the desert, these guys still prefer to live in areas that retain moisture that will encourage insects. The bark scorpion's favorite dish. While death rates in the USA are relatively low, over 800 people lost their lives to this scorpion in the 1980s. Rounding out our list at number 1 is the Indian red scorpion. Found mostly in regions of India, Pakistan, warmer parts of Nepal, and also Sri Lanka, the Indian red scorpion will likely be seen in humid areas with lots of vegetation, often very close to human settlements. It's not excessively big, typically growing around 8 centimeters long, but what it lacks in length, it makes up for in toxicity. Like other scorpions, the Indian red scorpion will be happy to eat anything it thinks it has a great chance of disabling. This won't normally be insects, but could even be lizards. With death rates after being stung of up to 40%, this is one critter you really want to keep away from. Most healthy adults will experience severe pain, vomiting, convulsion, heart problems, and more. But older people, and especially young children, can die from a sting from one of these guys. Well, that's it for this video. Thank you for watching as always.